888-785-0616. That's 888-785-0616.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You may bring up whatever you'd like. Just dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733, and you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that you'll find there on the site. Again, freetalklive.com. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
Derek J.
And if you care about online privacy, no matter where you are in the world, you need to know about ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network that encrypts your online data. Your internet service provider right now, they're probably logging all of the websites that you visit and the search terms that you're entering. You can put a stop to that by going to proxpn.com/FTL, download their software, and get it installed for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices. Linux users, it's also possible to get it rolling for you. It's just a little bit of a different setup. Go to proxpn.com/FTL to get started. And when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, and private torrenting ability, plus you can get past regionally blocked websites, you do it all for about $5 a month with discount code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live, and the number 50. So drop by proxpn.com/FTL. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. proxpn.com/FTL, code FTL50. Akko is with us. He's in Cameroon, Africa, calling from Bamenda on essentially last time you called, it was on a friend's laptop. You had purchased time from one of the local internet access providers. And I appreciate you taking the time to travel out of your way just to come talk to us here tonight, because, you know, we don't know what's going on in the rest of the world. We can't rely on the news media to bring us this information in any sort of meaningful way. If we hear a report about something happening in Egypt, we're hearing it through the lens of whatever mainstream media installation it was that decided to give us that report.
And likely they're hearing it from their local government.
There's a chance of that. I mean, some, you know, you take more as legitimate than others. Like, you know, I'll probably take RT when they're not reporting on Russia as being fairly decent in the way they report. But there's nothing that can compare to actually talking to somebody who's physically there, who's in the mix, who's on the ground. And we've got Akko here. Are you still with us, Akko?
Yeah, we also received the RT TV station here in Cameroon, and I really like it. But when it comes to presenting news from Russia, they seem to be a bit biased.
Oh, of course they are.
Yes.
That's because they're run by the Russian government.
Yes, they don't present a balanced news. It is absolutely unbalanced.
Well, if you take news from multiple sources, then you might be able to get a fraction of a picture of what's actually going on out there. So I appreciate you coming on here and just kind of talking about your experience there in Cameroon and what's happening. And Derek, it's your first time on with Akko, and so you've come up with a couple questions for him.
Yes, I am curious what you'd like from listeners. There are some folks who are in the chat room now asking what they can do to help.
They can send us some dollars, and if they send us some dollars, we can get more listeners connected to this network. Because most often, I have many friends and many listeners who come and spend the whole day in my room listening to your shows.
Wow.
But if we can make some fundraising, then we can get them connected, just like the way we connected the other guy.
And where do you do fundraising? I mean, where are people sending these dollars? Are they sending them to...
The last time the money was sent by Ian, Mr. Ian.
I just took in PayPal donations and totaled them up over a weekend, basically. And then whatever was in at the end of that weekend, I sent off
to
the Western Union.
I see. Okay, perfect.
And it actually wasn't as expensive as I expected it to be, because I've paid Western Union before to send money in the United States. And it actually cost me more, I think, to send money in the United States than it did with to send it all the way to Cameroon.
That's interesting.
Which was, I quite remember the last time the money was sent to me, Ian told me that the charges were affordable. They were not that expensive.
I mean, it wasn't as cheap as Bitcoin. I mean, it was only like $5 or $10 with Western Union. But obviously with Bitcoin, it's no next to zero cost. Did you ever figure out what you could do with the Bitcoin that I sent you, Akko? I mean, I realize that internet access is very limited there in Cameroon.
No, there is nothing we can do here with Bitcoins. We can only convert it into dollars and use it here.
Okay, but the big question was, could you find someone to do the conversion who wasn't going to scam you? So I'm wondering if you had, actually gone through with any of that conversion.
No, I cannot do it here because you will never find somebody who trades in Bitcoins. Nobody even knows about that. When I tell people that I have an online account with Bitcoins, people do not even understand what I'm talking about.
Mm. Yeah, I don't imagine smartphones are particularly well carried in Cameroon. What's the technical, when you're in the city, obviously you're going to come across probably some more wealth than you would out in the towns. But, are you familiar with the smartphone? Do you ever see people holding them in Cameroon? Is there even such a thing as...
I also have mine here, but they are not smartphones. They are just phones that you use to make calls and send SMS.
Yeah, just people, a cell phone. Okay.
Yeah, people cannot afford for money to buy something like iPhone 5,
right.
iPhone 4, all of those phones, or Samsung Galaxy.
Even in the city, does that exist? I mean, are there, certain like wealthier class folks who have those sorts of things, or is the service just not even exist at all? Like you couldn't...
Absolutely. There are many people who have it.
They do have it. Okay.
Now, you're in danger where you are. Some folks are asking, why stay?
I'm looking for ways. I will raise money and leave this country, because if this country continues like this, for people like us who are the youth of this country, we have no future. So the only thing is for us to get out and fight for the good of the people of Cameroon.
What's the general sense of the people? Do most people in Cameroon see Paul Boya as a dictator?
Absolutely, but they cannot voice it out. Everybody is afraid, because if you do, the secret service police, they will take you and go with you to a God knows where. So everybody is afraid to talk about the government, just like the way I'm doing now.
So they abduct people, they take you to who knows where. Are those stories that people tell, or do people actually know folks that that's happened to?
Yes, I myself, I know many people who went on missing for years, and when they come back, they are either maimed or they are either disabled
without
even knowing what happened to them. Because we are a bilingual country. Our own region here is the Anglophone region, mm-hmm. while the president, Paul Biya, he comes from the Francophone region. So we have this problem where we are being marginalized. For us, the Anglophones, who were colonized by the British, we are being marginalized. We don't
English
have
speakers.
Jobs.
So the Bamenda area is the English-speaking region of Cameroon, and you're saying
yes,
the rest
absolutely.
Of the country is the French-speaking
yes.
area. And it was
yes.
interesting, Derek J., I was reading about Bamenda, in the Wikipedia article, and it says that there's actually a secession movement there.
Hmm.
And when I was talking with Akko about it, he goes, yeah, that's our movement.
All right.
That's our movement. And many, many people have died in the course of that because it is called SCNC, the National Council for Southern Cameroon. They are fighting to secure an independence for Northwest, which is Bamenda, and Southwest, which is Boya, because we are being marginalized by this government. We are the minority. We don't have jobs. We don't pass exams to go into professional schools. We barely survive in this country.
The English speakers. You're saying that that's true of most of the English speakers.
Yes, we are the victim of that imperialism of the British and the French.
Wow.
They played politics over us. And now nowadays we are the ones suffering from that effect.
And
look at somebody like me. I am an educated person with masters, but what do? I have nothing to do.
Enough. I mean, you're doing a lot. You're putting your own personal freedom and on the line, and your safety on the line to try to express ideas, freedom related ideas, to people there. And you're actually putting money out to help people get satellite dishes. You've got these pictures I'm going to post on our Facebook and Google Plus here in a moment of the actual installation of one of these free-to-air dishes that allows the reception of LRN.FM, and that includes Free Talk Live and Freedom Fiends and all the other great liberty-oriented programs that are on that network. And that's 24/7
yes.
plus RT and those other channels.
Let me tell you how I connected that guy today.
Yeah, I want to hear that story. Hang on, Akko. We'll bring you back for that. And if you have any questions, Akko is with us from Cameroon, Africa. And it is past midnight there right now. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. More Free Talk Live coming up.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
The experts at Web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current Web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than Web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited here to take control of the airwaves even from very, very far away. Free Talk Live does broadcast on over 150 radio stations in the United States, including Guam and the Virgin Islands. But we're also heard in a good chunk of Northwest Central Africa, so kind of the middle swath of Africa. There's a whole lot of people living there, and many of them have these free-to-air satellite systems. And one of the reasons for that is because television is very, very restricted. Radio is very restricted by the governments in those areas, but they can't stop the signal from coming in from the sky. And so anybody with a relatively cheap receiver, at least from our perspective in Cameroon, however, purchasing the satellite equipment is a bit of a It's a lot pricier. You don't make as much money working in a week in Cameroon as you do in the United States or in Europe, for instance. And so buying something that to us would be just a $50 satellite receiver takes some serious time. In fact, I was talking with Akko about it offline at another time, and he says that usually people get them by making payments to one of the satellite installers. So, but once they pay off the equipment, the nice thing about free-to-air satellite is there's no subscription fee. So, you know, you pay for the equipment, it's not too expensive. It's not undoable, but it's just going to take some time in Cameroon. And then after that, you get LRN.FM, RT, Press TV, other channels. You get them all for free around the clock, which means there's information coming into these folks' homes that they otherwise wouldn't be able to get. They won't get it from the local television and the local radio. And they can't get it from the internet in a lot of places. For instance, Akko is not calling us from his hometown, but he lives in, and please correct me if I'm mispronouncing this, is it Ndop? How do you pronounce
Ndop.
That?
Ndop. It is called Ndop.
Ndop. So this is 40 kilometers away from Bamenda. There's no such thing as internet access in Ndop. And so free-to-air television is the way to get information. Into free-to-air radio, which is where we are, is the way to get information in. It's very exciting, and we're glad you're here again to talk to us, Akko.
There is something that just came up to my mind, what the government is doing. They are not only trying to limit us at the level of not going to school and having awareness of what is happening around us, even with regards to the problem of electricity. At times, we get electricity only once in a week. We stay in dark.
Oh my God.
They know that with electricity, we are going to have access to information, to TV networks, up and down, and then we'll come and...
So it's in Ndop, your town, where it's only once a week where you have electricity?
Yes, it is better here in Bamenda, but in Ndop, all the time we don't have electricity.
And that's just, it just randomly comes on? For how long does it come on?
At times it can stay for a week. If we are fortunate, it may last for a day or two.
Where does it come from? I mean, where's the power being generated from? Is it like a coal plant
It is generated from a hydroelectric source.
Hydroelectric. Okay, so water. It's coming from water.
Yeah. Yes. Most of the time, they will read it on the news and tell us that there is no water. That water is dry. That will not have electricity.
Do you believe them?
I don't. Is it true? I don't. Why is it that other areas in the same country that we are living in have electricity while others do not have? Just that
it's crazy.
We are the
it sounds like North Korea. I mean, in North Korea, they have electricity problems, and you know there they blame it on the United States attacking their power stations or something like that.
We are the Anglophones, the English-speaking part of this country. They are marginalizing us. Mm. They are limiting our potentials. They know that when we have access to all of these things, we are stronger than them, and that one day we can fight and get our independence and be on our own, something they don't want to hear.
No doubt. If you get your independence, that destroys their power and that destroys the whatever money they can extract out of this already poor people.
But that movement is still ongoing. Even at the United Nations, we have people who are fighting for that. One day, we are going to be an independent nation. We are going to succeed from this authoritarian regime.
Now you said it was the SCNC is the group that is sort of the secessionist group there. And Derek J, you were looking up some information about that, right?
Yeah, the Southern Cameroon's National Council. Are they recognized by the UN?
Yes, they are recognized by the UN. They even have people who are there fighting. It is not an illegal organization. It is not a terrorist organization, as this government will blame it. It is a legitimate organization because we came into an agreement with the French Cameroon and became a one country. And they are not fulfilling the terms of that commitment. So we are tired. They deceived us. We don't know what we are getting from them. So the best thing is for us to be independent. And there are people who are fighting for that. One day will come true.
Yeah, I'm reading here, learning from Wikipedia. It says that members of the government will regularly interrupt meetings and arrest members, typically detaining them for several days without release.
Yes, of course, with torture, and they can even maim you. They can disable you because many people have been disabled and maimed by these terrorists.
Particularly like the motto that's listed here. It says that it's a nonviolent organization with the motto, quote, "the force of argument, not the argument of force."
Oh, and there is nothing violent about that organization. It is an intellectual organization where people are fighting for their own right.
Well, that's the true threat. I mean, to have ideas. That is what is the real threat to the government. They can handle a guy with a gun or a few guys with guns, but they can't stop the ideas.
Yeah, they can't stop the ideas from flowing. We have people in the diaspora, in the United States, in France, in Germany, in Britain, and they are all aware of what is happening. But the speed at which it is happening is very slow.
Tell me about it.
To another level.
You know what, Akko, I really appreciate you coming on Free Talk Live here and sharing your experience there and taking some personal risk to do so. Thank you for sharing our program.
I have a message for you from listeners in Cameroon.
Oh, please.
They are saying that they want to come here and have a show with you, that I've been the only one coming here to have a show, that all of them, they want to come here and talk to you.
Would like to bring some guests. Sure, I think that'd be fine. Yes. Would love to talk to some more people. I actually got a contact from a guy who's a listener in Ghana recently as well. So there's quite a few people listening over in the African continent, probably more than we're even aware of. And it's part and thanks to you and your efforts. And Akko, I'm going to post up a couple of these pictures on our Facebook page so folks can actually see one of these satellite dishes being installed, which of course is bringing more information to more people. Was there more that you wanted to share tonight that we didn't cover?
I just want to say your ideas of liberty is not limited. It has no boundary. It has no color. We are all the same. You are living in the United States and we are living in Cameroon. We all have the same problems. We all have the same predicament. And one day with these ideas, our life is going to change forever.
It's beautiful.
Wow.
I love it. Thank you, Akko, for the call tonight, and thanks for keeping us informed, and we'll look forward to hearing from you or your friends again in the future.
Thank you very much. Yep. I will be back on the show very soon.
Yeah, be safe
out
there.
Thank you, Akko.
Thank you.
Thank you, Derek J. It's nice having the show with you for the first time.
Yes, likwise.
Have a safe trip back to Indop, and thanks again for the time tonight. That's Akko calling from Cameroon via Skype. It sounded great. I mean, all things considered, as far as the internet connection.
I am amazed. Sounds better than some of the callers who call in from cell phones here locally.
Yeah. Well, it actually was fun. One of the times I talked to him online, I asked him, hey, can you just run the speed test? Because if you go to speedtest.net, that's a good way to test your internet connection. You click on a server that's nearby. Like here, I click on a Boston server and I can see how fast the studio connection is going. I was just curious as to what his results would be. And they weren't very good. It was like 600 kilobits per second downstream.
But that was enough for him to get his voice carried
through. More than enough for voice. Yeah, for sure.
Well,
sure.
It sounded high quality, and I have some more questions for him in the future. I can't wait till he comes back. I want to know what other ways the government is limiting people. I couldn't believe that they, of course, government censorship of the media is nothing new. It happens all over.
Well, I mean, it's right. I mean, it's going to be the same old ways, right? I mean, one of the ways I can predict it is you know, you can't start your own business. I bet you that's one of them, because that's a great way to keep people in the dark and keep them poor, is to prevent them from creating wealth for themselves rather than having to go and work for somebody else. That's one of the ways they do it here in the U.S. I bet you it's the same thing there.
Yeah, I just think about, you know, when governments say, oh, you can't hold banners, you can't have demonstrations and protests. Oh, you know, big deal. We pass notes in class. We could pass notes in real life, too. I can't imagine the government can effectively stop communication among people.
No, they certainly can't. They can't. But if you are speaking out openly, then they're going to target the people that stick their heads up in that way. That's what they do here. You know, well, they target the person they perceive to be the leader of a protest, for instance.
Well, that's why I'm so grateful for people like Akko, and I hope there are more of them.
Yeah, it's awesome. We'll share the pictures here on our Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter of one of these satellite installs that some of our listeners helped fund. Remotely, which is pretty cool. 855-450-FREE. There's plenty to talk about here tonight as well. Besides what's going on in Cameroon, there's a lot in the world, and this is Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Monday, December 29th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,196, silver around $16.08, and Bitcoin is trading around $313.36. Today's precious metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Today's broadcast of the Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. With civil unrest occurring all across the country, being food secure has never been more important. Visit eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, Congress is expected to make important decisions on the future of commercial unmanned aerial vehicles, or drones, in 2015. The Obama administration is also expected to release proposed rules on drones as well. The Federal Aviation Administration will reveal their propositions by the end of January. The Associated Press reports it could take 2 to 3 years for regulations to go into effect. Representative Peter King has called out New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio for being non-responsive in helping to get federal funds to sick 9/11 first responders. Representative King is calling on the mayor to put to use $326 million in federal funds for first responders. King calls de Blasio's foot dragging frustrating. Show your efforts in holding police accountable for their actions. John Bush explains.
There's still time to get your entry in for the copblock.org Why I Film the Police video contest. The deadline is Wednesday, December 31st, 2014 at midnight Eastern. CopBlock is looking for videos no longer than 1 minute where you share why you film the police and why you believe it's important for others to film the police. On January 2nd, all videos received will be published on copblock.org and the public will be given the opportunity to vote for their favorite video with polls closing January 11th, 2014. Three winners will be announced January 14th on CopBlock Radio. To learn more or to enter your video today, visit copblock.org/why-i-film-the-police.
The Liberty Beat is made possible by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online, shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Did you know you can support the Liberty Beat when shopping on Amazon.com? Just log into your account after clicking our Amazon affiliate link at libertybeat.com/Amazon. That's right, you can help the Liberty Beat continue to deliver hard-hitting Liberty news and activist updates by doing your Amazon shopping after following our link at thelibertybeat.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, December 29th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. Protesters in Houston will gather this afternoon to demand the Houston Police Department fire an officer who killed an unarmed Houston man. Jordan Baker was shot and killed by Officer Jay Castro in January 2014. A grand jury recently decided not to indict Officer Castro, sparking a new wave of protests in Houston. The demonstrators are calling for the immediate firing of the officer. They will meet at 1201 Franklin Street in downtown Houston at 3 p.m. The Central Bank of Ecuador held a press conference on Christmas Eve, announcing the launch of its national EMS or electronic money system. The system is designed to move the nation to a completely digital currency operated by the central bank. The EMS will roll out in three phases over the next couple of years, with users eventually able to make bill payments for water, electricity, and taxes. The creation of the new money system also brought on the banning of Bitcoin and all other cryptocurrencies in Ecuador. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your messenger product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To get the details you need to take advantage of this great offer, visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, December 29th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a...
Sources within the Vatican confirmed Tuesday that Pope Benedict XVI has dispatched an elite team of six bishops to sabotage leading contraceptive manufacturer Pfizer. Codenamed Conclave 6, the highly trained team of bishops will reportedly infiltrate the heavily guarded compound, detonate extremely powerful charges at key points within the factory, and then escape to a nearby safe house.
The Catholic Church can trust only the best with defending God's plan. Conclave 6 is the deadliest team of bishops I've ever laid eyes on.
The Pope denied rumors that a B-team of needle-wielding priests had been deployed to a latex factory in New Jersey to poke tiny holes into thousands of Durex condoms. Locally, the best part of a gay 12-year-old's day is the half hour he spends eating lunch alone in a stairwell. Calling it his only respite from constant ridicule and mockery, 7th grader Ben McElroy says life doesn't get better than the moments he spends quietly laying out his lunch on a secluded staircase while the rest of his classmates are in the cafeteria.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can bring up anything that's on your mind. You just dial in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, Ian here.
And Derek J.
Don't forget to check out more Derek J on his website, derekj.me. I saw on your list of things to do, because we live together here, so I see your to-do list on a regular basis. You are catching up. You've been busy kind of getting stuff done, scanned in, writing stuff up for whatever it is that's coming next at DerekJ.me.
Oh, yeah. There's some hearings coming up because, you know, some court things, taking the police to court, all that. I've got details at DerekJ.me.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I don't want to spill the beans yet.
Okay, no bean spillage then. All right, so DerekJ.me, you can get more of him there. He does a lot of radio stuff, too, and you'll be picking up the ball again this week with fresh episodes of Peace News Now and Cop Block Radio?
Yes.
Excellent. I know many listeners are looking forward to it after having heard reruns for the last week, so it's good to have you back.
It's good to be back.
Cranking out the content over at DerekJ.me. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. I teased this at the beginning of the program. The SWAT teams. This was a shock to me that this has actually come out now in mainstream media. There's been a conspiracy theory, Derek J., for a while now that says that governments are corporations and that you can actually find them on, like, the stock listings or whatever. Dun & Bradstreet, I guess, which is a company.
What?
That
always made me raise my eyebrow.
Didn't it seem weird? That's an interesting claim. And it's funny, too, because you can actually look into it and find that,
But it seems
they're
like
they're on Dun & Bradstreet.
Well, I don't know what that is, first of all.
It's some sort of rating company. Like, they rate the economic viability or something of different corporations, I guess.
Well, second of all, none of the politicians who run for these offices seem to know anything about it. So it doesn't seem to be a requirement to know about this corporation to work for it. That's a weird thing.
Well, I think a lot of people know that a city is considered a municipal corporation. That's not an uncommon phrase to hear uttered in reference to a city government, that it is called a municipal corporation. But one of the, and the claims of the conspiracy theorists go on beyond that. It's just that you can see these listings publicly. Like, you know, if you go to the Dun & Bradstreet website and you look up your local court, it'll probably come up. And that's because it's its own corporation or something like that. Now, I don't know if that means shares of it are traded. I think that's what the conspiracy crowd has been suggesting all along. You know, how deep...
They're bought and sold!
How deep it goes, I don't really know. I
have no idea.
To some extent, the conspiracy world is a very dangerous rabbit hole. But it's interesting when you hear things like this now coming out in the mainstream media. This is the Washington Post. Radley Balco is the author. As part of the American Civil Liberties Union's recent report on police militarization, the Massachusetts chapter of the organization sent open records requests to SWAT teams across the state. It received an interesting response. As it turns out, a number of SWAT teams in the Bay Area are operated by what are called Law Enforcement Councils, or LECs. These LECs are funded by several police agencies in a given geographic area and overseen by an executive board, which is usually made up of police chiefs from member police departments.
That sounds like a bureaucratic mess.
In 2012, for example, the Tewksbury Police Department paid about $4,600 in annual membership dues to the Northeastern Massachusetts Law Enforcement Council, or NEMLEC. That LEC has about 50 member agencies. In addition to operating a regional SWAT team, the LECs also facilitate technology and information sharing and oversee other specialized units, such as crime scene investigators and computer crime specialists. Now, I don't know if this is just Massachusetts that has these LECs. Certainly the first time I've heard about it. That doesn't mean they haven't existed forever. Some of these things have apparently incorporated as 501c3 organizations with the IRS.
Wait, isn't that like nonprofits?
That's correct.
What?
And it's here that we run into problems. According to the ACLU, the LECs are claiming that the 501c3 status means that they're private corporations, not government agencies. And therefore, they say they're immune from open records requests. Let's be clear, says Balco. These agencies oversee police activities. They employ cops who carry guns, wear badges, collect paychecks provided by taxpayers, and have the power to detain, arrest, injure, and kill. They operate SWAT teams, which conduct raids on private residences. And yet they say that because they've incorporated, they're immune to Massachusetts' open records laws. The state's residents aren't permitted to know how often SWAT teams are used, what they're used for, what sort of training they get, or who they're primarily used against.
Nah, that's not going to stand. The ACLU is going to take that on. It's going to flop.
Because come on, about that.
Come on, that's too flagrant of a violation. How dare they say that people have no right to know what's going on inside the police departments? Oh, because we came up with this little loophole where we made ourselves a nonprofit. No one's going to buy that.
From the ACLU of Massachusetts report on police militarization in that state, approximately 240 of the 351 departments in Massachusetts belong to an LEC. While set up as corporations, LECs are funded by local and federal taxpayer money, are composed exclusively of public police officers and sheriffs, and carry out traditional law enforcement functions through specialized units such as SWAT teams. Due to the weakness of Massachusetts public records law and the culture of secrecy that has infected local police departments and law enforcement councils, procuring empirical records from police departments and SWAT teams, regional SWAT teams in Massachusetts about police militarization was universally difficult and in most instances impossible. Police departments and regional SWAT teams are public institutions working with public money meant to protect and serve the public's interest. If these institutions do not maintain and make public comprehensive and comprehensible documents pertaining to their operations and tactics, the people cannot judge whether officials are acting appropriately or make needed policy changes when programs arise. No kidding. Now, if you thought that the police didn't have accountability before now, this should be a real shocker and a wake-up call. Like, they're now claiming that we don't even have to answer your questions because we have a corporation. And, of course, that's what corporations are for. Corporations exist to protect people from legal liability for their actions, and here they're providing the police departments with that protection.
At least the lie used to be an emotional one. It used to be, we're protecting you. You know, like, you can't know because, you know, that would compromise our security. You know, like, oh, you can't know our practices because then you'll figure out how we do things and the criminals will take over. But now they're not even going with an emotional argument. They're trying with a bad logical argument. Like, well, see, we are actually not a government agency. But no, you are. You're cops. It doesn't get more government than that.
It's just a real, I think, indicator of how bizarre this world, this legal land world, really is. People don't understand, you know, the intricacies of what's going on with these government agencies. They're constantly trying to subvert their own rules. Whatever few rules that they have, they're constantly trying to get around them. And this is yet their next tactic here. Well, we've formed a corporation. Now we don't have to tell you anything about what we're doing. We don't have to give you any reports now.
Yeah, we actually don't have any rules that we follow. I mean, that's what they seem to be saying.
It's the
here.
Illusion of them having rules, right? That they purport themselves to have rules.
There are plenty of rules for me.
Correct.
They give me lots of rules to follow.
They talk about it's a law, you know, society or a nation of laws, etc., and that it's their job to enforce them. But yet, when it comes time to actually obey their own laws, they just find ways to work around them. And then, usually, almost always, the other branches of this supposed check and balance system don't check anything. They just sit back and let it happen.
That's so slimy. So, what do you do? What's the solution? I would think that grabbing a video camera and doing some investigative journalism would be the solution. I mean, if they're not going to give you their own stats and numbers, I mean, why not try and go down to the police departments and get them yourself? No, I'm not saying by force. I'm saying by observation.
Yeah, well, I wonder what it would be like to try to get into one of their board meetings. I bet you they would try to close people out of those. Like, I want to go, if I were in New Hampshire and there was one of these LEC things in the area. And I know they have some sort of regional agreements between police departments, but I don't know if they're set up quite the same as in Massachusetts. But if I were in Massachusetts and wanted to do this, you know, look into this, I'd try to find out where they met and go to their little LEC powwow session and, you know, do some Dave Ridley-style ambush interviews outside.
Sounds like they need it.
More coming up here in moments. 855-450-FREE. There's a little bit more about these LECs, as they are called. These essentially corporations made up of government police departments, and they're saying that that protects them from revealing information about what their activities are. What do you think about that? 855-450-FREE. Does that make you feel safe and secure? 855-450-3733.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. Congress is given legislative power by Article 1 of the Constitution. Congress's powers are limited, but they are vitally important. Congress can tax, raise an army, pass immigration laws, but if a power isn't listed or clearly indicated by the Constitution, Congress may not act. The 10th Amendment reiterates this point. Powers not delegated by the Constitution remain with the states or with the people. This fact may often be difficult to see given the powers Congress claims for itself. Consider interstate commerce. Congress does regulate it, but they have interpreted this power so broadly that they now strictly control transactions that aren't interstate or commerce. That's not what our nation's founders intended. It's not even in the text of the Constitution. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, December 12, 2014, gold opened at $1,216.60. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,261.34, $630.67 for a half ounce, or $315.33 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,261.34, $630.67, and $315.33.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you'd like. Just dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Derek J.
And if you care about Bitcoin, or maybe you're just curious, the place to be in 2015 is March 28th and 29th at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin, Texas, for the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. Mark and myself had the opportunity to attend the first Texas Bitcoin Conference. It was a great event, and I think this one's going to be even better because this one's going to take place in the heart of downtown Austin. The last one was kind of out in the sticks a little bit, so I'm excited about the new location. I think it's going to bring it to the next level. Speakers, exhibitions, a great opportunity to do some networking, and they'll be hosting the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. It's the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. They'll highlight what Bitcoin means to everyone, as well as concentrate on where the technology can go beyond just being a currency. If you want a glimpse into the future, you'll want to be in Austin, Texas, March 28th and 29th. Go to TexasBitcoinConference.com, get your tickets, And when you use code FTL, you'll save $25 off the already very affordable $150 admission price. So knock another $25 off of that by using code FTL. And also another $25. So $25 off gets you $125 as the total cost. And then $25 of that will be going to Sean's Outpost when you use code FTL. Sean's Outpost is a great Bitcoin accepting charity, homeless-based charity out of Pensacola, Florida, and they're doing good work. So TexasBitcoinConference.com, use code FTL. We were there last year. Looking forward to seeing you there in 2015 at TexasBitcoinConference.com. As we continue here with what is, I think for some, it's going to be a shocking story about the Massachusetts regional SWAT teams saying to the ACLU, yeah, we don't have to respond to your freedom of information requests. So yeah, you want to know about how often we use the SWAT team and in what instances? What were the circumstances surrounding the use of these SWAT teams? Well, we're not going to answer your questions because we're a private corporation. Sorry. Private corporations are, you know, we don't have to answer these inquiries. These freedom of information requests only apply to government agencies. And because we're not a government agency, well, sorry.
Now, don't they have a valid argument in one regard? Yeah, they're sort of playing fast and loose with the rules that they've set up for themselves. But then again, they're the ones who set up the rules for themselves that say that the Freedom of Information Act request is something that I'm amazed they even comply with at all.
Barely.
They came up with this rule that says we have to tell you what we're doing, and they do that on occasion. They will let you know what they're doing when you ask them. So, yeah, what's so shocking about them saying we've changed our mind about that?
I think the shocking part would be that they're actually claiming to be a private corporation now.
Yeah.
Like they're coming right out and saying, oh, yeah, we're not even a government agency anymore. Now we're just a private company. Which is crazy. I mean, it's just, I think that would be an unusual thing. I was shocked to see that in a headline at the Washington Post, number one, because that seems like something you'd see on some crazy kook conspiracy website.
It really, I'm trying to think of the reverse of this would be a private corporation saying that they're government. Could you imagine like Walmart or Krispy Kreme saying like, we're government now.
Yeah, no one would understand what that meant.
Wait, what?
So you're welcome to share your thoughts here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Jay Noon. He's in Massachusetts, and you deal with these guys, these government guys down there all the time, Jay. Well, you're welcome to share your thoughts. Go ahead.
Yeah, actually, I'm on the land of Massachusetts because being in Massachusetts would mean I'm in this nonprofit corporation that's registered in Dun & Bradstreet, which I'm not. In fact, I have fun with that with cops on the stand because they're
really
– if you do a DMV.com search for Commonwealth of Massachusetts, there's like, last time I did it, there was almost 30 different corporations registered their Commonwealth of Massachusetts, whatever.
Hmm.
And they are actually, what they are is they're charitable organizations. And as you guys know, I got a lawsuit against the town of Palmer. And the town of Palmer responds as, and I quote, defendant, Town of Palmer, a municipal corporation. When you look at any of the Town of Palmer documents, it says Town of Palmer, a municipal corporation that is a government or that calls itself a government, governmental, AL. It's a very important part. As we all know, the suffix AL on the end of a word means similar to or like.
Okay.
So they're similar to or like a government, but they're not actually a government. And this is I've been saying this for 10 years, and
But for all of those, I mean, look, I love what you say, Jay Noon, and it makes sense to me. But it doesn't matter to the courts, right? Because they're backing
them up. It doesn't. It doesn't. Anybody can Google Clearfield Doctrine. It's United States versus Clearfield Trust, like 1932. And what the Clearfield Doctrine says is basically that all government agencies are at the level of a mere corporation and that they must have a contract or an agreement with whoever they bring their statutes against. Well, I brought this up in Land Court, although we don't care. I brought this up in U.S. District Court when I sued the town. My complaint got dismissed. I brought this up in Appeals Court. Also, I brought up taking land without a jury trial and all that stuff, and they won't say touch any of it. But everyone's corrupt. As far as I'm concerned, they're all taxable, or they're all charitable organizations, and the courts, everything, and they're all totally corrupt. There is no more government because the government should be us, the people.
I don't know if it's like this in the Massachusetts Constitution, but in the New Hampshire Constitution and in many others, it always says there's always some sort of language in there about that it's, you know, by the consent of the governed. And that, you know, that the government exists. And clearly that's not true either, because you can't tell them that you don't consent. I've tried and they just don't care. And so I'd heard actually, Jay, that you'd called on one of the nights in the show that I wasn't here, that you had announced that the feds had tossed out your case. So, you know, yes. You can't get justice, even though I think what you're saying is true and it makes sense to me. You know, that these guys are corporations. That's how they're organized. Of course, corporations are this imaginary fiction, you know, legal fiction that was created by governments in the first place. So, you know, what came first, the chicken or the egg? I don't know. It's all very confusing. But ultimately, when you break it all down, they're just men and women ruling over us by the threat of force. And no magic words have ever been able to save us from that.
That's right. And, you know, I really feel the best answer is the Free State Project, and it's, you know, if all of us guys get up there in numbers, and I'm going to be getting there as soon as I can myself, I think that's where we're really going to have an actual movement, and hopefully everybody can kind of even more agree on something to kind of try to do something to really make, you know.
Well, this is where it's all possible. Whatever it's going to be, whatever it's going to take to achieve liberty in our lifetime, I truly believe that in New Hampshire, that's where we're going to see it happen, because we've got concentration of people here who care about liberty and who are willing to do something about it. Tomorrow morning, we're going to court to back up our friend James Cleveland, who is facing 2 years in jail because he stood up for his rights and stood up for the rights to be the free press and was arrested for his efforts. So, you know, we've got that level of support here in New Hampshire that most people don't have anywhere else. Jay Noon, thanks for your call tonight. Always appreciate hearing from you. Look forward to seeing you back in New Hampshire as soon as possible. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Boy, wouldn't it be nice if you could just, you know, tell the government guys, I don't consent. Thanks, but no thanks. Don't need your services. Have a nice day. And then they'd leave you alone? That's all we want, right? More coming up here in moments. This is Free Talk Live.
It's that time of year again, and you know what that means. Cold and flu season. But don't worry. HerbalHealer.com has you and your loved ones covered with our safe and natural products. Cold and flu fighters like beta-glucans, olive leaf antiviral capsules, grapefruit seed extract, HHA 4-herb capsules, elderberry power, and respirate. And don't forget about oregacillin for the lungs, normally $34.95, on sale now for only $25. Vitamin D3 120-count soft gels, only $9. Whole body and homeopathic detoxes for the lungs, kidneys, liver, lymph, and brain, normally $26.95, now just $20. HerbalHealer.com also offers correspondence courses to teach you how to handle your health naturally. And as always, new customers get a free 128-page catalog with your order. Visit HerbalHealer.com and click the Winter Specials button to save on our natural cold and flu-fighting products. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Now, how much money will all those closeted Republican convention goers bring into the city, Marie?
A lot. The average area prostitute normally makes around $200 to $300 a week, jerking off truck drivers behind the bus station.
I see.
Next week, they are expecting to make 30 times that amount, sucking off secretly gay Republicans.
Wow.
You figure the fact that these delegates are so repressed and filled with self-hatred,
yes,
they tend to like the filthiest, kinkiest sex acts imaginable.
Oh, that's
right.
Which
tends to cost more. The average well-adjusted gay man has no desire to smear fecal matter all over his partner's face or be beat up by him. But that is exactly the sort of thing that these repressed conservatives are willing to pay top dollar for.
Okay, as well as the services of transsexuals, I understand.
Yes. A lot of the Republicans repeatedly call the prostitutes faggots or start crying after they've had sex with them.
I suppose the prostitutes are shoring up on their politics so they can talk to the Republicans.
Ha ha, Andrea, what do you think this is, Pretty Woman? They're just there to get
right. Thank you, Marie Byron.
Oh, RNC's always a good time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused.
Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. How would you feel if you found out your police department was claiming to be a private company? Would you feel at that point obligated to continue sending them money? Because if it's a private company, then it's not the same thing as a government anymore, right? So maybe that would be a good excuse for folks in Massachusetts to withhold their property taxes at this point. Hey, you know, I thought this was a government, but I'm only supposed to pay taxes to the government, but here now your agency is saying they're a private company, so I would like to cancel my service, please. You know, like you can cancel your Comcast service or Time Warner service. Shouldn't you be able to cancel the government service? Oh, no, you can't do that either. Because then the very same SWAT team's going to come to your house. And then they will take you physically from your home if you haven't paid them. And if you don't go with them into the streets, then they'll go ahead and they'll physically take you from your home if you're still alive after the encounter.
How much longer till they advocate for just open burning of records? Like, we don't need any records. Let's just throw them in a
Department
fire.
Department 451. Metro LEC. This is from the Washington Post's Radley Balco. Metro LEC. They're talking about these LECs, which is an acronym that is essentially stands for Law Enforcement Councils. And they have these law enforcement councils around Massachusetts. Now, maybe this is going on in your state as well. I don't know. This is the first I've heard of this. Maybe it's one of those things where they're doing it in Massachusetts, and if they get away with it, then we'll start seeing them pop up elsewhere. Or, for all I know, they're already in all 50 states. I really don't know. It's the first time I've heard of LECs. So Balco is telling us about these LECs. They're claiming 501c3 corporate status, which they say means they don't have to respond to Freedom of Information Acts. This is an excerpt that the Washington Post is sharing from the ACLU of Massachusetts and their report on this. The ACLU goes on here saying, hiding behind the argument they're private corporations, not subject to the public records laws, these LECs have refused to provide documents regarding their SWAT team policies and procedures. They've also failed to disclose anything about their operations, including how many raids they've executed or for what purpose. Metro LEC, one of the largest of the law enforcement councils covering the metropolitan Boston area, operates a range of specialized resources, including a canine unit, computer crimes unit, crisis negotiation team, mobile operations, SWAT, motorcycle unit, and regional response team, in addition to its SWAT force. The organization maintains its own Bearcat armored vehicle, as well as a $700,000 state-of-the-art command and control post. It's probably one of those big RV things that you've seen, like the truck trailer size things that pull around. In 2012, Metro LEC reportedly used its Bearcat 26 times, mostly for drug busts, and applied to the Federal Aviation Administration to obtain a drone license. The Northeastern Massachusetts Law Enforcement Council, NEMLEC, similarly operates a SWAT team as well as a computer crime unit, motorcycle unit, school threat assessment and response system, regional communications, and incident management assistance team. Its SWAT team members are trained and equipped to, quote, deal with active shooters, armed barricaded subjects, hostage takers, and terrorists, unquote. And they dress in military-style gear with the words NEMLEC SWAT emblazoned on their uniforms. Given this training, it's not surprising the NEMLEC SWAT team has over the past decade led numerous operations that involved armored vehicles, flashbang devices, and automatic weapons. You know, it's interesting. Some people complain that the liberty movement or voluntarists are arguing for private police and that, you know, that this was what we would want to see. We would want to see a private police, Derek J. Shouldn't we be happy about this?
No, because as you pointed out, you can't say no to them like other private things. Like I brought up how bizarre it would be if a private corporation just suddenly decided it was a government corporation like Krispy Kreme or something. Like, you must buy Krispy Kreme.
The government of Krispy Kreme.
Yes, and now everyone must buy them every month, whether you want them or not. Mm-hmm. Just like health insurance.
Sir, have you bought your mandatory minimums today?
Yeah, or you'll get a punishment from the IRS.
You don't have a chocolate in here. You need to have at least one chocolate.
There's no cream. Yeah,
I don't see any filling in this one over here. That's a fine.
So bizarre because, yeah.
Get back in the kitchen. We're putting you to work.
With donuts. Shops and with coffee shops, any other place, you can say, no thanks, I don't want your service, sure. I'll go for someone else. But with SWAT teams, you don't get that choice.
Massachusetts, by the way, has a long history of accountability and excessive force problems with SWAT teams. That is, accountability problems with SWAT teams. A few examples: in 1988, Boston detective Sherman Griffiths was killed in a botched drug raid, later revealed to be to have been conducted based on information from an informant, and a subsequent investigation revealed the police had simply made that up. 6 years later, the Reverend Aceline Williams died of a heart attack during a mistaken drug raid on his home. The Boston Globe found that three of the officers involved in that raid had been accused in a 1989 civil rights suit of using fictional informants to obtain warrants for drug raids. In testimony for that suit, one witness testified that after realizing they just raided the wrong home, a Boston police officer shrugged, apologized, and said, "This happens all the time."
So they weren't accountable when you did have the records. What's the difference? We don't have them now. They weren't accountable then. They're not accountable now. Yeah. You know what it sounds like we need? Like another cop watch, cop block, cop. There needs to be a watch the watchers where you scan the scanner or something, you know, because there's like these police scanners that you can get on your iPhone or smartphone. You can listen and hear what your local police department is doing. You know, it would be a nice service if some volunteers would just say, like, this is what the police are doing. I heard them, you know, and so you don't need to rely on the government's
listeners.
You don't need to rely on the government's own information because they're going to lie to you anyway. They're going to cover up and they're going to obfuscate and say, oh, we don't need to give you that. Why don't you just go get it yourself? I mean, it would be great if independent citizens could be relying on each other rather than depending on the government for this type of information.
You remember when the Keene riots were happening here during Pumpkin Fest that made international headlines? Our scanner actually went down that night due to, of course, you know, it's one of those things. Of course, when people actually want to tune in, it goes down. But it was probably also due to the high demand because when normally if I were to go there right now and look and see how many people are listening to the Keene scanner, the police scanner, it's usually no more than five at any given moment. Right now, there are six people listening. But the night of the Pumpkin Fest, we hit over 300 simultaneous listeners on that scanner. So to have that tool out there enables people who want to know to tune in and at least find something out. You still don't get to know everything because there's still the little two-way typing system they have, you know, those laptops in their cars. They can send text messages to dispatch as well. So if there's certain information they don't want revealed over the public airwaves, then they'll just text it. Yeah. Now, there's supposedly a way to get that information through Freedom of Information requests. I just don't know of anyone who's ever actually gone through that, at least for that particular info. In 1996, the Fitchburg SWAT team was already facing a lawsuit for harassing a group of loiterers when it burned down an apartment complex during a botched drug raid. Whoops. The SWAT team subsequently faced a number of other allegations of recklessness and misconduct. In January of 2011, and by the way, he's obviously glossing over a bunch of cases. He's giving you a summary of some of what's happened. In January 2011, a SWAT team raided the Framingham, Massachusetts home of 68-year-old Yuri Stamps at around midnight on a drug warrant. Oddly, it had already arrested the subject of that warrant, Stamps' 20-year-old stepson outside of the house. But because he lived in Stamps' home, the team went ahead with the raid anyway. Now, the ostensible reason for these raids is that there could be someone inside who might shoot them, right? That's the reason they've got all the armor and the machine guns and they're amped up and they're kicking in doors and doing that sort of thing. That they may
they think Scarface is behind every door.
Right. And they also the claim is that the drugs might get flushed or something. Like if we don't go in fast, they might flush kilos of cocaine.
And that would be horrible.
And now, are they going to argue that the 68-year-old grandmother here, or grandfather, I'm not sure if Yuri's a man or... I'm not sure. Anyway, that this elderly person, if this individual is the criminal that they were making their stepson out to be? I mean, this is a completely only a related individual who happens to live in the home, but they still went through a SWAT raid. And during that raid, when they encountered Mr. Stamps, the 68-year-old, they instructed him to lie on the floor. He complied. According to the police account, one officer then moved towards Stamps to check for weapons. He lost his balance and fell. As he fell, his weapon discharged, sending a bullet directly into Stamps' chest, killing him. Now that sounds like a likely story, doesn't it? I just shot the man in the back. How does that happen exactly? Unless you are holding the man at gunpoint the entire time with your finger on the trigger, there's like next to zero chance that a bullet's going to end up in someone's back if you aren't pointing the gun at the person, right? 855-450-FREE. More about these private cops coming up.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-856-4195. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-856-4195. That's 1-800-856-4195. Call 1-800-856-4195.
Hi, I'm John Rainey, Chief Financial Officer of United Airlines, and I'm honored to be the National Chair for the 2015 March for Babies campaign for the March of Dimes. United is a proud supporter of the March of Dimes mission to improve the health of babies and fight premature birth. We're helping the March of Dimes fund breakthroughs in research and community programs that help more mothers have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Please join us in working together for stronger, healthier babies. Visit marchofdimes.org.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, Buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3. Give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can take control of the airwaves here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It may be the last week of the year, but we're still here doing live radio for you. In fact, New Year's Eve, you'll be able to join us for yet another live edition of Free Talk Live. So please be with us throughout the holidays as we're here for you at 855-450-FREE. You can also join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Shocking story in the Washington Post from Radley Balco, who is basically one of the key players out there in reporting on all things police state. He is revealing some what I consider to be pretty surprising information, and that is that government agencies are now coming together in Massachusetts. And please, if you know about this in other states, let us know. This is the first I've come across this. But the idea is that these government police agencies have teamed up to form LECs. Now, the LEC stands for a Law Enforcement Council. And they have different LECs throughout the state of Massachusetts. And what these things do is they operate SWAT teams, among other things. According to the ACLU, one of those LECs, Metro LEC, also operates a canine unit, computer crimes unit, crisis negotiation team, mobile operations motorcycle unit. Goes on and on. All kinds of different things besides just a SWAT team. And now these LECs are saying we don't have to respond to freedom of information requests because we're a private corporation.
It's like the League of Extraordinary Criminals.
You can't have it both ways, says Jesse Rossman, a staff attorney for the Massachusetts ACLU. He said this in a phone interview with Balco. The same government authority that allows them to carry weapons, which you can't do in Massachusetts, make arrests, and break down the doors of Massachusetts residents during dangerous raids also makes them a government agency that's subject to open records law. In some states, police agencies can claim exemptions, this is Balco again, from open records legislation for certain types of requests, such as for internal personnel files or investigation documents that could reveal the identities of witnesses or informants. So even under the rules as we thought we understood them, there's still some exemptions. But now they're saying they're exempt from everything. And going on, some parts of the country, like the Virginia suburbs of Washington, police agencies have broadly interpreted open records laws to allow them to turn down just about every request. But this claim in Massachusetts is on a whole different scale. Rossman says they didn't even attempt to claim an exemption or an exception. They're simply asserting that they're private corporations. The ACLU is now suing one of these LECs, NEMLEC. It's worth noting that in addition to receiving taxpayer funding from its 51 member police agencies, NEMLEC has also received significant federal funding over the years, particularly from the Burn Grant Program, whatever the hell that is. In fact, just last April, NEMLEC made a series of drug busts across the state in an investigation funded at least in part with these Burn Grants. They seem to be involved in quite a lot of drug raids at this NEMLEC. In 2010, they received an $800,000 burn grant earmarked by John F. Kerry at that time. Interestingly, in 2009, NEMLEC had to pay out $200,000 to settle allegations that it made false claims related to the use of Justice Department grant funds, specifically funds obtained through the Burn Grant Program. That sounds like an agency that could use a little oversight. The argument that the LECs in Massachusetts are private corporations and therefore immune to state open records law was made by Jack Collins, who is the general counsel for the Massachusetts Chiefs of Police Association. So the top dogs in Massachusetts politics inside the system, not the politicians themselves, but the police chiefs, who essentially are politicians. They're just, I don't know if they're elected in Massachusetts. Here in New Hampshire, they're appointed by the city council or the city manager. And what I don't know here is, well, what it seems like is that these guys have gone together and they have concocted a way that they believe is going to get them around any level of accountability whatsoever for their actions. Now, in theory, you would still be able to submit a request to the individual department to ask for records about what their department alone was doing. But anything they were doing under the name of this NEMLEC or METROLEC or whichever LEC that we're talking about, they're going to claim was exempt from those records requests. So I imagine they're probably trying to put as much under the umbrella of these LECs as they can possibly get away with.
This is why, to me, it's so important to film and record the police at every opportunity, because they don't want to tell you what they're doing on a regular basis. I mean, this isn't like, oh, we're not going to tell you what we're doing on Tuesdays. This is all the time. They are keeping the public from this information.
I wonder how far we are away now from these cops making the claim. Let's say you walk into a Massachusetts police department with your video camera, as many of us have done over time. Even though we're here in New Hampshire, we've gone down.
Weren't you arrested for that?
I was arrested for walking into the town hall, which housed the police department, but by the time I...
You didn't even get there.
I didn't get to the police department by the time I was arrested. That wasn't the reason I was actually there. Oh. So I ended up getting an inside tour of the police department without my intention.
Without the camera on.
Yeah.
Okay, but no, this is why it's important to record the police, but you say
but how
different?
Far are we... No, I'm not saying different. I'm just saying how far are we now before some police agency says, hey, turn that camera off. This is private property.
Oh, you know, they've tried that on a couple of places, like at federal detention centers in New York City. I know there's videos
really?
Of these. Yeah, because security guards, they don't know what they're doing. And a lot of times they just make it up as they go along. Oh,
that's
yeah.
certainly true.
Yeah, this is a private property. Oh, is it? You know, this is a jail.
Right. So who owns this private property?
Yeah, so a lot of those questions will make them go away. But yeah, it's an interesting thought.
Yeah, well, what if they take this NEMLEC? Right, what if they take this NEMLEC group or METROLEC and they have them purchase the police station?
Oh,
then the
yeah.
police station could be a privately owned building that's rented by a government agency.
I don't know. You gave the numbers on those. They seemed kind of low. I don't know if they don't include the federal numbers, but you said 50 times about $4,000. It gives them about $200,000 operating budget, right? So
wait a minute. Where did you get those numbers from? Was that said?
Yeah. Yeah. So you said there's like 51 police departments in this one little area, little region.
So it was Tewksbury.
They gave an example of one town,
yeah,
gives it about
Tewksbury.
$4,000.
$4,600 in annual membership dues.
Yeah. So I'm estimating maybe they got $200,000 to operate with. That's not a lot of money for a department.
But
I mean,
that doesn't
do
include grants either, right? So if they got the Bearcat or what this $700,000 state-of-the-art command and control post.
Yeah, I guess the feds chip in quite a bit more than the local municipalities can.
So I have to wonder, you know, are these LEC things happening in other states or is it just Massachusetts? Is this becoming a nationwide epidemic that we don't even know about?
How
it
can
sounds
we
like
know?
Balco just found out about it.
Well, how did he even know? Do you file a Freedom of Information Act request in your local police
That's what happened was the ACLU filed Freedom of Information Act requests.
And they were just
looking
like, nope.
Filing with them with all the SWAT teams in Massachusetts looking for details on, all right, well, you know, in the last year, how many times was the SWAT team used? And they
ACLU,
came back and said, nope, not going to tell you.
And the ACLU has been following this for a few years. They've been sort of making a long case, I think, against the militarization of the police in general and these
I think the case has been made
SWAT
at this point.
And tanks yeah. in particular. But yeah, I think they've sort of reached the end of the rope, haven't they? If you can't get more information from the government
yeah,
about the
end.
SWAT teams, it's like, what do you do? So I guess they're going to
They're
court.
Suing. Yeah, they're suing. So, you know, we'll see how that pans out. And if we come across that information here, we'll certainly share it with you. But if you come across it first, you know, if we haven't talked about it yet and you've heard about the news that this, you know, case went one way or another, please call in and let us know via the toll-free number 855-450-FREE. We rely on a lot of our listeners to keep us in the loop.
So this is why I left the ACLU. I was a fundraiser
really?
With the ACLU in Philadelphia. And when I saw time after time, in my case it was for Guantanamo Bay, but I just saw that they're not able to do what they want and because they
try. The ACLU is not.
The ACLU. And I'm not saying that their goals are not virtuous, but they're not able to do what they want because they try and hold the government to its own standard. And that just is impossible. You can't do that. What do they do? They reach the end of the rope. They have to take the government to court. What court?
The government court.
So what do they expect?
Well, I mean, they're trying. At least they're trying. And in some instances, they do have success. It was this Massachusetts ACLU that helped me out in Massachusetts when I was arrested for having a video camera in a town hall. And it was their attorney who secured a $5,000 settlement for me, which, you know, is chump change compared to Carla Garrick, the president of the Free State Project. She got $57,000 in a similar case in Weir. So
what was the difference there?
The difference was, I guess they had him on the ropes better in Weir or something like that. I forget you know, the ins and outs. I was in town hall. She was on the side of the road.
Seems like a big difference in you know, the amount of money that you're awarded.
You never know what you're going to get, right? Like the, what's I don't know.
Like a jackpot? You just hit bingo or something? And they
might
just
as well.
Choose a number at random?
Yeah, I think so.
Weird.
Like, hey, you'd be happy with this? Okay, sure. Done. So, you know, credit to the ACLU. They're the ones who took the case. And
they didn't do some good.
They didn't have to at all. So, I mean, the group here in New Hampshire, they also took on the Occupy case, which was the occupiers who were arrested in one of the parks in Manchester for basically being in the park after 11 o'clock at night. The ACLU of New Hampshire took that case. But they took the case.
Not trying to put them down. I'm just trying to point out their hands are a little tied.
Of course. Yeah, they're working within the system. You can only do so much. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. There's more coming up here in moments on Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, December 29th, 2014. Silver is trading at $16.11 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,193 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $319.
Antiwar.com reports, for years, the U.S. was wondering what it was going to do with many thousands of war vehicles it shipped to Afghanistan when the drawdown left so many of them in surplus. At times, they talked about giving them away or shredding them. Instead, 3,100 such vehicles have been sent to Kuwait, where the U.S. is massing them for use in the ever-escalating war against the Islamic State. Officials simply found another war for them. The bulk of the vehicles are MRAPs, used by ground troops to resist IEDs and travel, and that points to the buildup being done with an eye on an eventual U.S. ground war in Iraq and Syria. U.S. Transport Command says that the Army has room to hold all the gear in Kuwait and is simply storing it there until they figure out what they have a need for. History suggests they'll invent needs for it if nothing immediately springs up.
Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com.
The Associated Press reports a high school basketball tournament on the Northern California coast has become the latest flashpoint in the ongoing protest over police killings of unarmed men after a school was disinvited because of concerns its players would wear a t-shirt printed with the words, "I can't breathe," during warm-ups. The athletic director at Fort Bragg's high school informed his counterpart at Mendocino High School this weekend that neither the boys' nor the girls' teams would be allowed to participate in the three-day tournament hosted by Fort Bragg High starting Monday. Mendocino Unified School District Superintendent Jason Morse said the boys were reinstated after all but one player agreed not to wear the shirts, inspired by the last words of Eric Garner, the New York man who died after an officer put him in a chokehold. Too few girls players accepted the condition for the team to field a tournament squad. Mendocino High varsity teams first wore the "I Can't Breathe" shirt before a game with Fort Bragg on December 16th. According to the girls' coach, Caden Feehan, the girls also wore them before games at two other tournaments and did not receive any blowback. Professional basketball players such as LeBron James, Derrick Rose, and Kyrie Irving wore "I Can't Breathe" shirts during warm-ups this month without repercussion from the NBA.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Mexico on Sunday called for an overhaul of the United Nations Security Council, envisioning more member countries across a wider geographical swath as the government steps up efforts to raise its profile on the global stage. Tasked with maintaining global peace, the UN Security Council meets when war looms and cooperates in efforts to solve international disputes, with measures ranging from sanctions to military action. The council has five permanent members: China, France, Russia, Britain, and the United States, and 10 temporary members elected by the UN General Assembly for two-year terms. In a statement, Mexico's foreign ministry said it wanted the 10 temporary members to grow to 26, with six members coming from Africa, five from Asia, four from Latin America and the Caribbean, five from both Western and Eastern Europe, and one from small developing nations. However, Mexico said it was against changing the five permanent members on the council. The proposal comes just a few months after Mexico said it was ready to take part in the United Nations peacekeeping missions after years of staying out of the world's conflicts. Mexico has traditionally pursued a low-key foreign policy, but since taking office in 2012, Mexican President Enrique Peña Nieto has sought to raise Mexico's international standing. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Shortly after beginning his first date with area woman Pauline Geary, smitten local man Brad Holtman told Onion reporters he couldn't believe that the woman was also a fan of the 1960s British rock band, The Beatles.
We were just talking about music, and she mentioned that she liked The Beatles, which is crazy because
I love the Beatles, actually. Yeah, funny thing is, I was not really even looking forward to the date. I figured we'd get a drink or whatever, but it's turning out a lot cooler than I thought it was going to. I mean, she's just such a huge fan. She knows all the Beatles' names. She even owns some of their albums. I've been a Beatles fan since like 6th or 7th grade, so I don't want to get too excited and jump into something. So I think I'm going to ask her if she's ever seen The Godfather, which is probably my top 5 movies of all time.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can take control of the airwaves here. Toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Many listeners will find it hard to believe, but we actually have a positive story about the police here tonight. It is a rarity, it seems like, these days to come across such a story. Derek J., you have it. Where's it from?
Reason.com, and they're not that, I mean, yeah, they're kind of rare, but I find them, and I think they're worth focusing on because there's enough people focusing on bad police.
I think it's important to point out when they do the right thing. I mean,
yeah.
when somebody does something wrong, we should let them know that, and when somebody does something right, whether they're government or whether, you know, government people or their friends in our lives, it's important to communicate how we feel about stuff. So, you know, when they get it right, I like to give them some appreciation and say thank you.
Exactly, and let other police departments see how it could be done.
All right.
Nashville police responded peacefully to protesters. That made some folks upset.
The kind of people who wanted to see some truncheons striking heads or boots crushing into skulls on the pavement, those kind of people.
Who will think of the children? I don't know. I guess it's that kind of people.
Yeah,
it's,
of course. There's a certain type of person who wants to see the hippies get beat up by the cops. I mean, there's just those people exist.
Scott Shackford writes at Reason.com, hundreds of protesters marched into downtown Nashville in November, upset, as were some people in other cities, that Ferguson, Missouri, police officer Darren Wilson would not be indicted for shooting and killing Michael Brown. The protest was peaceful, but did block some streets for a while, including Interstate 24. The Nashville police and its chief, Steve Anderson, decided not to respond with militarized force and orders to disperse. I think that is amazing.
That's refreshing.
Good. Decided not to respond with militarized force and orders to disperse. Hooray for him, the Nashville police and their chief, Steve Anderson. So the police closed the affected streets to keep the protesters safe, you know, from the cars, and offered coffee and hot cocoa to marchers who arrived in front of the downtown police station. So they weren't going out of their way to give these people hot cocoa. They gave it to people
if
as they came
by the station.
As they came by the downtown police station.
That's very nice.
I think that's a great thing to do. Most places, you know, we serve
Let's
coffee.
Let's hire this guy for Keene.
Right? come on over here, Steve. So, I mean, most places that have coffee have extra cups, have extra lids.
Sure.
They've got an extra pot. They
you
can make more coffee.
You guys do it at the thrift store. You guys give away coffee.
We give away coffee. Anyone can do it. If you make coffee, you can give away coffee. So they were just being friendly and nice on a November evening. Now, local African American church leaders were pleased with how Anderson responded, but not everybody was happy that the Nashville police didn't show the rabble-rousers who was in charge. As part of a Christmas message to his officers, Anderson shared with them an angry email from a citizen who wanted to know why the police didn't knock some heads to keep the community safe. So here's his response to the writer as well as the exchange. He says, first, this is the person writing to the police chief.
Okay.
I wanted to send you this email to express my frustration and outrage at how the situation of these protesters is being handled in Nashville. Now, you would expect there's some violence or something must have happened if there's some outrage and frustration. But no,
people just hate protesters.
The first night, protesters marched here after the incidents of Ferguson. They never should have been allowed to shut down the interstate.
Well, and, I can understand. It was the interstate? That's pretty unusual.
That is unusual. Now, instead of at least threatening to arrest them, they were served coffee and hot chocolate. I don't feel that is an appropriate use of taxpayer dollars. It sends a message that they can do whatever they want and will be rewarded.
Oh.
Now, what do you think about that, Ian? Is that fair?
I don't think so. I think it sends the message. I think it sends a different message. I think it sends the message that, hey, maybe we don't understand completely what you're saying, but at least we empathize with your ability to be able to have these protests without being struck, attacked, handcuffed, arrested, detained, etc., and let it happen. That way, the it's probably one of the smartest moves they could make, because it may sort of short circuit the protest in a way. Like, oh, you know, maybe the protesters were expecting to have the police respond to them in sort of a violent, typical manner, what you might expect to see happen out of like New York City. And then they didn't. The cops responded in a friendly manner. They assisted the protest. They helped facilitate it in a way, and thereby it went away. Has a protest happened since then in Nashville?
Well, actually.
Really?
Then this past week, more protesters marched around downtown for 3 or more hours, and then once again, no arrests, and it took Tennessee Highway Patrol to keep them from getting on the interstate again. Saturday night, marching and die-ins at Opry Mall's Mills Mall. Hmm. How long are we going to allow these people to disrupt our city? I have a son who I have raised to respect police officers and other authority figures. Well, good for you, lady. But if he comes to me today and asks, why are the police allowing this? I wouldn't have a good answer.
Mm.
What would your answer be? If any other group of people wanted to march around the streets, they would have to get a permit weeks or months in advance. And I know it's not possible to get a permit to obstruct traffic and walk down the interstate.
Well, yeah, she's probably right about that.
So I'm going to skip the rest. We get the sense of her grief.
She's outraged.
Here.
Outraged at this. Yeah.
Yeah, she goes on and, you know, she says it's not personal. She just wants some order in her city.
And he said
his response.
Right? Okay.
Although this is unlikely, given your zero tolerance stance, suppose that by accident or perhaps inattention, you found yourself going 40 miles an hour down a 30-mile zone and you were stopped by a police officer. Then, after making assurances that licenses were in order and no outstanding warrants, the officer asked you not to speed again and didn't issue a citation, but merely sent you on your way. As you've suggested, a question may come from the back seat. How can I respect the police if they do not enforce the law? In the event this does occur, here are some facts that might help you answer the question. This is brilliant. Coming from Steve Anderson, Chief Police in Nashville, in the year 2013, our officers made over 400,000 vehicle stops, mostly for traffic violations. A citation was only issued in about 1 in 6 of those stops.
Okay.
Five of the 6 received warnings.
Wow. Okay, good for them.
That is serious kudos. I think that's amazing. Good job, guys, that you're not handing out these tickets all the time. Good for you.
That makes me curious as to what the stats are here in Keene, because when you look at the police logs, there is a fair amount of warnings given out here in Keene. And I think that part of the reason, and maybe it's similar in Tennessee, but part of the reason is the money that they generate from those tickets doesn't go directly to the department. It goes to the general fund. That's, as I understand it, it does not go to benefit directly to the department. So therefore, they don't have that same incentive that some departments have to where the more tickets they write, the bigger the department's budget.
It could be a matter of incentives. It could also just be a matter of common sense.
Could be.
So this is the explanation that you might give your son. This is the police exercising discretion for minor violations of the law. Few, if any, persons would argue that the police should have no discretion. And though there are some people who will argue that, because they think,
it's a nation of laws.
Yeah, if the police can make up their own rules as they want, then there are no rules, right? So take into account that the innocence of children can produce the most profound and probing questions. They often see the world in a clear and precise manner. And he may ask you, if you believe that the police should enforce the law at all times, why don't you insist that the officer write you a ticket?
Now, he read this to his officers, right?
He wrote this in a Christmas email. He sent the
Did
email.
Did he send it back to her, too?
Yeah, that was the exchange that he and this woman had. I just thought that was a great example of exercising discretion, showing common sense.
He seems to have compassion. Do I dare say that he seems to have empathy?
Humanity, yeah. I love to see this, and it should be highlighted. Because there are plenty of stories of police doing the wrong thing.
I've got them.
Here's the police doing the right thing, and they should be applauded for it.
Well, I will give them some applause for that one. I mean, there's nothing to critique in that, really. I mean, what can you say bad, from our perspective at least, a peaceful perspective, what can you say bad about this man? And at least in this instance, who knows what else he's done, but you know, I'm sure his department's probably still arresting drug users and things like that. And there's probably things to critique about the Nashville Police Department, but in this instance, I got nothing to critique.
Yeah, sure. So, if you added a little rum to your coffee or something, they might have had a problem with that.
But. Kudos.
Good job, guys.
They're probably adding rum to their own coffee. Eight knowing cops. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can share your thoughts. Bring up whatever's on your mind here on Free Talk Live. More coming up in moments.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Hey, I'm Ian Freeman, one of the hosts of Free Talk Live. I created Free Talk Live in 2002 as an alternative to traditional talk radio. I wanted a show where anyone could call in and bring up any topic without fear of being screened out. Combined with our libertarian, voluntarist viewpoints, Free Talk Live is a unique syndicated radio show heard on FM and AM radio stations, coast to coast and beyond. I moved from my birthplace of Florida to New Hampshire in 2006 as part of the Free State Project. I'm also the program director of LRN.FM, which I launched in 2009 to create a place to present the best liberty-oriented audio programs from around the globe. I perform liberty outreach of all sorts and have done civil disobedience, non-cooperation, and run for office multiple times. Much of that's covered on my blog at freekeen.com. Thank you for listening to our shows, and if you want to support our work, please visit amp.freetalklive.com and contribute just $5 a month to our effective liberty outreach. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live, and you can take control of the airwaves right here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733, and you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. You can enjoy all the features there. We give them away to you. Those other talk show hosts, they charge you for their sites. Ours is free. Also free, coffee. You get a pound of some of the best coffee out there from BuzzBox by going to coffee.freetalklive.com. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica. It's great coffee. And it's competitively priced with other high-end coffees, because what happens is you get on the auto-ship program. You get your first pound shipped for free. You just pay the shipping cost. And then you get future pounds, or more than a pound or less than a pound. You can adjust the amount that you receive. You can adjust the frequency that it is sent. You get on their auto-ship program, and of course you can cancel your subscription anytime. But one of the things that makes BuzzBox coffee special, besides the fact that it's great coffee, is that some of the money goes, the profits from each pound, go to fund microloans. Free Talk Live and Kiva.org have teamed up to do this, where we are, you know, basically giving microloans out to people in very difficult parts of the world in which to live. And we're able to actually give out one microloan every single month for every 10 listeners that orders coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. So it's an amazing program where you get great coffee, you enjoy that at your leisure, and people around the world are helped out by these microloans. So go to coffee.freetalklive.com. We talked about some really amazing cop news about good cops in Nashville, Tennessee. The police chief there actually helping protesters. He didn't help them smash storefront windows or anything like that, but he just helped them have a peaceful protest. And it was a really kind of a refreshing story. Well, we've got another story for you from the New York Police Department. We'll let you guess if this one's a uplifting occasion. But first, Alma is with us listening in Tallahassee. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Alma.
Hey, sweetie pie.
Hi there.
You know, I've been listening to you. You know, we agree to disagree. That's the way we are.
Okay.
But, you know, this sounds like the Purge to me, and I get really upset. I go, why in the world are the police letting these people tear up people's businesses? That was my business. I would be very upset.
Wait a minute. Now, what are you talking about? Where did this happen? Are you talking about Ferguson?
Oh, yeah, everywhere where they're tearing up stuff. These protesters.
Well, just to be clear, that didn't happen in Nashville. There weren't any reports that I'd heard of about protesters destroying private businesses there. That's only been in some places. I don't even believe there were allegations
California
of that in New York City.
California was the worst one here lately.
Oakland?
It was 30 businesses that got, I mean, busted.
That's terrible. In some cases,
business.
Actually, Alma, it is the police who will instigate those activities. They might not
I don't doubt that anymore.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on because they're standing back, and I'm going, heck is going on here? It's no reason to the season.
Yeah, well, I can understand the confusion, and I've seen this happen here in Keene when we had the Pumpkin Fest riots that
went on here. I've heard y'all talk about that a lot.
Yeah, they stood by. I went on one of the streets. I was the one who got the video footage of the rioters throwing this huge bottle war. It was like a 10-15 minute long, just constant stream of bottles being thrown in the air between a huge crowds. I mean, we're talking about hundreds of people on one residential street. And yeah, if you look up Pumpkin Fest 2014 riots on YouTube, you'll find...
I don't have to. I've listened to you.
You'll find the video, and it's pretty shocking. The more shocking part about it that some people might, you know, not really believe is that the police were literally around the corner, and they knew that something was happening. They knew that there was a violent fight going on, essentially.
I'm telling
you, they did nothing.
I agree with you. I think there's something behind all of this because they wouldn't stand back and allow this.
No,
wait a minute. They might get hurt.
Yeah,
they might get hurt, Alma. There's nothing more important than officer safety.
That's not it.
That's what they claim. Thanks for the call, Alma. I appreciate it.
That is not the reason. No.
Thank you for the call.
I'm smarter than that.
I appreciate it. I don't know if there's a conspiracy. It sounds like she was getting at that.
I don't think so. I mean, I've seen it. It's the same everywhere. It's the same in Philly, same in Keene. Police don't want to get hurt. They want to stay in a safe place.
I don't blame them. I mean, who wants to get hit by a flying bottle or a pool cue? Apparently some crazy fool was throwing a pool cue around.
Hey, you collect the
stick, the ball.
You collect the same pension whether you get knocked around or you get nothing. So you might as well stay safe.
Yeah, and the pension, you know, if you don't have to nurse broken head, on your pension. That'll probably give you more money to spend on the wife and kids and the house.
Jet skis, whatever you do.
Yeah, so, I mean, I don't think there's some sort of grand conspiracy involved in that. I think it's just laziness, number one, or number two, fear of, you know, possibly getting hurt. And, you know, I can't blame someone for avoiding a conflict like that. But in the police's role, they're supposed to sort of – don't they claim they run towards danger rather than away from it? That's like one of their big claims to fame.
Yeah, they say never attribute to malice what you can attribute to ignorance. I would say the same is probably true of laziness.
For sure. Let's go to David. He's in San Francisco. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Derek J.
Hey, howdy, y'all. Happy New Year.
Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, Happy New Year, and Happy Yalda, too. We just got over that one. Hey, you know, I was interested in this. I saw there was a quote by Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, the basketball player, about the police incident. You know, basically, as a taxpayer, we own the cops. And if there's a bad cop on the force... Well, yeah, I mean, it is true, whether or not you take advantage of it or not.
There's no proof that it's true.
Well,
if you own something, if you own something, you have control over it. That's the one of the definitions of ownership, is that you have, and generally, exclusive control. But, you know, in this case, you could claim you're a part owner. But even then, your wishes are not respected by the thing that you supposedly own. Like, for instance, when Derek J. was doing his victimless crime spree, and you didn't know you were doing it at the time, but it turned out that that's what it was. We made a movie about it, victimlesscrimespree.com. And one of the scenes of the movie, there's a we're in Central Square. It's a park right in the heart of downtown Keene. Derek, you're about ready to light up a bowl full of what was ostensibly marijuana. And they arrested you for this. But prior to the arrest, there was actually a vote taken by the people who were in the park that day. There were a number of people there to support you, and others were just hanging out in the park. And there was this police presence out there. And people said they took a vote. And how many people want to – raise your hands. How many people want these police to leave the park, to go away? And almost everyone in the park, I think, except for the police, raised their hands at that point. So it was pretty clear what the people who were supposedly owned the police, was what you claimed, David. It was pretty clear, right, what they wanted, but the police ignored that. So clearly we don't own them.
Well, it's good that you're challenging it on that realm because, you know, ostensibly if one comes to your door and your door is unlocked, they, according to the Supreme Court, they have the right to come in whether or not you invite them in or not because your door is unlocked. And that's pretty creepy.
Yeah,
but
creepy.
Out here in San Francisco, we've gone through probably 10 different police chiefs in about 20 years. And so we have a better handle on them, although I won't say that we have a complete handle because there's a kind of a famous Kenneth Harding case that still hasn't been resolved. But the point I was going to say, and this Kareem...
Isn't San Francisco where that BART cop shot the guy in the back?
Well, BART is a different jurisdiction. That's a municipal train system that runs into 3-4 counties. So they're on a whole different schedule. But well, I hear the music. Can I hold over?
I'll let you hang on, David. More in a moment. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. He's claiming they've got the cops under control in San Francisco. I don't know if I believe that. We'll come back with more here in moments, especially in big cities. Police are even more out of control, tends to be that way. 855-450-FREE. You can bring up anything here on Free Talk Live.
I lost 18 pounds in just 4 days. Hi, I'm James Zetta. If you're like me, you've already tried and failed at many diet and weight loss plans. The 18 and 4 weight loss plan requires no exercising, no diet pills or additives, no laxatives, no meal replacements, and no diet drinks. The 18 and 4 program is crystal clear with a day-to-day, step-by-step, and meal-to-meal guide. If you're not satisfied with your results, I will give you my 30-day full money-back guarantee. Go to 18and4.com. That's the number 18, I-N, the number 4.com.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com. The future of talk radio. Now at your fingertips.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself.
it called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101ReasonsFilm.com. 101ReasonsFilm.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited here to dial toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, it's Ian here.
And Derek J.
Check out more Derek J on his website, derekj.me. It's a blog, and it links to all kinds of different media programs that Derek involves himself in, some of a video and audio nature, like Bitcoin Talk Show. That's one of them.
That's right. And Cop Block Radio. We also talk about peace news and other Bitcoin stuff on the Bitcoin group.
So go check it all out at derekj.me. As we go back to David, he's in San Francisco claiming they've got it under control. In San Francisco, the police are under control by the people and everything is just copacetic there. Is that right, David?
Well, I wouldn't say we're under control because this is a thing of eternal vigilance.
Uh-huh.
But we have gone through almost 10 different police chiefs in 20 years.
Isn't that an idea? Doesn't that suggest that things are unstable in San Francisco? That, you know, if you actually had a decent police chief, that you'd be able to keep them on for a little while?
Well, that actually gets right to the point of why I was calling. There was a thing after World War II called Project Gladio, G-L-A-D-I-O. And one of the techniques of Project Gladio, and this was that the Nazis were to be put in positions of power, and that just do a Google search of specialized knowledge and abilities, that quote, specialized knowledge and abilities, and you'll realize that there are Nazis that have made their way into police, fire, every position of power. Of course, everybody knows they're in the weapons program and in the CIA and whatnot. But the idea
this is news to me. I mean, so what you're saying is that this was a World War II program to put Nazis into political power or to bureaucratic seats of power in the United States?
Absolutely.
Why? You said everybody knows that. That's the first I've heard of that story.
Well, this has been written about probably for 50 years.
And so you're saying that they've been passing it down through the generations, that those, you know, because obviously a Nazi in the 40s isn't going to be the same Nazi in the police chief, office today.
When I lived in Denver back in 1990, there was the mayor of Castle Rock, Colorado, which is south of Denver. His son was caught burning a homeless man to death. He and a buddy had set a homeless man on fire in the middle of the night, and as they were trying to escape, they caught him.
Now, is that because Nazis or just a-holes?
Yeah. No, they were Nazis. And
was
there
evidence
police
of that? Did they find swastikas or something, or what?
Study the case, because there were Nazis on the police force in Denver, and there were a number of street thugs that were killing people in order to gain street cred.
Well, there's plenty of racist cops out there. I just don't, you know, it's the first I've heard that there's some sort of organized attempt by Nazis to take over positions of power. It's an interesting theory. David, thanks for the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And, you know, when somebody says, we've got it under control here in San Francisco, which is basically what he said in the last segment. He kind of said that he didn't say that, but that's what I heard him say. Said they had the department under control, and then cites having 20 different or 10 different police chiefs in 20 years as an example that things are under control. That sounds like things are in constant state of upheaval there. In fact, there's a news story coming out. Didn't take much Googling to find this one, published within the last 3 weeks. San Francisco police corruption scandal triggered by surveillance videos that appeared to show officers as thieves registered its first verdicts on Friday when federal court jury found two veteran officers guilty of stealing property and thousands of dollars in cash from drug dealer suspects to enrich themselves and defraud the city. Jury took 3.5 days of deliberations to unanimously find Officer Edmund Robles guilty of 5 felony charges and Sergeant Ian Firminger guilty of 4. Jurors acquitted them of 4 charges, including conspiracy to deprive the public of their honest services and deadlocked on a theft charge against Firminger. Scheduling of sentencing has happened. According to the story here, they have now had to dismiss more than 100 criminal cases because of the police misconduct exposed by these videos. So the people they charged things with, they had to uncharge them because these officers were corrupt.
Interesting.
And stealing.
Well, there's a victory.
Friday's verdicts, according to one of the prosecutors in a statement, or excuse me, this is a public defender, said, bring measure of justice to the victims who were ripped off, falsely arrested, and disbelieved for far too long. These 12 jurors sent a message that there are consequences for bullies who victimize the poor and powerless under color of authority.
What consequences? What was their punishment?
Well, the sentencing has yet to occur, so this is pretty fresh. Sentencing is set for February 23rd. They will be sentenced to who knows how much time.
A desk job.
They've actually been suspended without pay since the charges came on, and I guess the police chief does say he's going to try to have them dismissed from the department.
Oh.
But as far as the sentence is concerned, you know, that we are talking about felony charges here, 4 and 5 felonies respectively here.
So isn't there a way, so someone commits a sex crime, for example, then they're on the sex offender list for the rest of their life. They can't live in certain places. Mm-hmm. They can't get certain jobs. Isn't there some equivalent for police?
For bad cops?
Yeah, who abuse their power or are found to be stealing on the job, for example. Is it so crazy for me to suggest that they be blacklisted from becoming a police officer again?
That is possible. It's not easy to do. There's so many different examples of a police officer who's been removed from one department for misbehavior who then gets hired across the state by another department. So it does happen a lot. There was a story actually that I published over at freekeen.com today, based on a union leader report about a police chief here in New Hampshire who threatened a college girl with, she had some criminal charges. He said, look, you come down in the basement with me, I'll take some naked photos of you.
Oh,
and
God.
If you're a good girl for 2 years, I won't let those photos out or something like that. Holy
moly.
And she walked out of the station. She didn't actually go downstairs with him and ultimately went to other police, and they brought this guy up, not on charges. They brought him up with just, you know, like, you've been a bad boy, shame, shame. He resigned, and then...
Oh, go get a job at a new department.
They claim he's been blacklisted. They claim he cannot get a job as a police
officer.
Yeah,
well, I don't buy it. I'm not taking their word for anything. Mm-hmm. I want to see more, you know, We Watch the Watchers types groups. It sounds like there's a real niche that needs to be filled in that regard, because the police aren't giving us their own information. They're not going to watch themselves.
The officers in the San Francisco case, by the way, worked in the plainclothes unit at the Mission District Station. They were charged with taking and dividing up thousands of dollars found during searches of drug dealers and their homes. Vargas testified about a series of incidents in 2009 in which he or Robles, his partner, swiped cash and other items from the homes of dealers that they had arrested or were investigating, and then sharing the proceeds with Firminger, their supervisor, rather than booking the property into evidence. On one occasion in May of 2009, this was Reynaldo Vargas. I didn't mention him earlier. He pleaded guilty. He has yet to be sentenced as well. So you had one guy pleading guilty who was testifying against the other officers. And when that happens, it can be pretty... You know, once the thin blue line is broken by one officer, it can be very difficult to try to keep it together at that point. And so you have one officer testifying against the others, they're going to go down. And they did. They searched a home as an example. It's only one example here. In May of 2009, Vargas says the officer searched the home of a drug dealer in Newark, a target of, it's in San Francisco, I guess, target of a federal investigation. And Vargas found $30,000 in cash buried in the backyard.
Of a cop's house? Or
this is a suspect or a drug dealer, suspect. Alleged drug dealer. He said he, Robles, and Firminger, who were the two that were found guilty by the jury, divided up the loot on the drive back home. The next day, according to prosecution testimony, Mr. Robles deposited $6,000 in cash into his bank account.
Yeah, nothing unusual about that.
On another occasion, Vargas said he took two Apple gift cards from a dealer's home and used one of them to buy an iPhone, while Robles used the other to get an iPad for his girlfriend. She testified that she received it. In closing arguments Monday, U.S. Attorney John Herman called Vargas a dirty cop who nevertheless could be believed because his testimony was backed up by independent evidence like Robles' convenient bank deposit. So there's one example. It didn't take me long to find that example of San Francisco police not being so good. And in this case, they happened to get caught. Remember, these were veteran officers. They'd been with the force for 20-some years. 19 and 22 years, respectively. More coming up here in moments. So you have to ask yourself, how long were they doing this kind of stuff? And how many other officers are as well? It's Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
I'm a mid-century architectural wonder, a house made entirely of glass. So you can imagine my fright when giant pieces of hail started falling from the sky. Did I mention I'm made entirely of glass? Everyone was running here, running there, trying to get out of the house, but what am I to do? I am the house.
Your house can't protect itself. That's why the Geico Insurance Agency helps make it easy to switch and save on homeowners insurance. You could save even more when you combine your homeowners with an existing auto insurance policy. Call Geico, go to geico.com, or visit your local office.
It's that time of year again, and you know what that means. Cold and flu season. But don't worry. HerbalHealer.com has you and your loved ones covered with our safe and natural products. Cold and flu fighters like beta-glucans, olive leaf antiviral capsules, grapefruit seed extract, HHA 4-herb capsules, elderberry power, and respirate. And don't forget about oregacillin for the lungs, normally $34.95, on sale now for only $25. Vitamin D3, 120-count soft gels, only $9. Whole body and homeopathic detoxes for the lungs, kidneys, liver, lymph, and brain, normally $26.95, now just $20. HerbalHealer.com also offers correspondence courses to teach you how to handle your health naturally. And as always, new customers get a free 128-page catalog with your order. Visit HerbalHealer.com and click the Winter Specials button to save on our natural cold and flu-fighting products. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
I just heard the best sales pitch I've heard in a long time on an airplane. The flight attendant announced, "If you paid more than $75 for your round-trip ticket, you overpaid." This is brilliant because everybody on the flight paid more, and I was struck by how all the road warriors stopped typing and reading and working and looked up. The announcement invited us to apply for the airline's credit card, and the sign-up bonus? Enough frequent flyer miles for a free round trip. Talk about turning lemons into lemonade. With some banks offering free credit cards, $75 is an outrage for an annual fee, but a bargain for airline tickets. For more tips on communicating more effectively, hit survivalspeech.com, where you can see how I got the CEO of another major airline to shower me with freebies. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here to bring up whatever you'd like at 855-450-FREE. That's toll-free number 855-450-3733. We have Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. As we continue with your calls and thoughts, David is listening in Florida. You're on Free Talk Live. David, where are you? Panama City area?
Yeah, Lynn Haven, all right. Actually.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah, I've called y'all before and everything. I've actually called you from work and everything when I'm at work and everything because I do security and such. You know, and I'm not mad at you guys and okay. such.
Good.
But I want to know, is having a lawless society a good thing?
Well, obviously, I don't want to live in a place where people are openly murdering and raping and pillaging. That would be a terrible thing. What would make you ask
right.
that question?
Okay, right. Because I don't want a lawless society. I don't want anarchy in this country. And such. I mean,
I'm with you. When I don't want to have men in uniform or out of uniform going around and threatening and taking and stealing, and that's what we see the police doing on a frequent basis. So.
Right. And I'm from a law enforcement military background, and that's been my family's background. And there are good cops. There are bad cops. I'm not going to say that they're not, because there is. And I do, the guys that go up and they go to school and everything, and they learn the laws and everything, and they go to work for law enforcement agencies, they're told to uphold the laws and stuff. When new laws go into effect and everything, well, they have to uphold those laws.
No, they don't. They can... As you know, as you should know, as a law enforcement officer, you can use discretion, which is what Derek Jay was talking about earlier this hour, where the Nashville police used some discretion when going up against speeders as well as protesters. So, no, they don't
right.
have to enforce the laws.
And they can give them a warning saying, don't do it again.
Sure. But or they can just look the other way. They can do that, too.
Right. And if cops keep getting, hear me out for a minute.
Okay.
If they keep saying, okay, well, I'm going to look the other way for a minute and everything, and then that same person does it again.
Does what?
Well, they look at the and then they look the other way again.
The question is, does
well,
what?
That person just,
obviously, they shouldn't be looking away on a murder, but if they want to look
well,
the other way
murder,
on a stop sign violation, that's okay with me.
Okay, not murder, okay? But the law is saying, okay, this person sells meth and everything, and they just let that just let that fall under the rug. Well, that person sells it again. They let that fall under the rug. Sweep it under the rug. Okay, it's not hurting anyone.
Okay.
Okay.
Fine by me.
And then, okay, you know, when these little laws, when these little violations just kept getting swept under the rug and stuff, eventually somebody's going to get hurt from it.
What do you mean?
You not agree with that?
Like someone might overdose?
Overdose, a child might get hurt, or whichever. I mean, have you ever worked in law enforcement, ever worked in a prison? Because I worked
no,
in
but
prison
I've been
for
in
like
jail.
7 years.
I've been in jail.
Okay. So you know
drugs
what
get in jail, too, you, by the way. I'd like to let you know that
okay,
you know,
well,
war on
yes,
drugs
I,
isn't working.
Trust me, I have seen that.
Okay.
I have seen it brought into jails and everything. I've seen it brought into prison systems and everything.
Well,
and
kids can get hurt by
I've
reaching into their grandparents'
one.
Medicine cabinet. I mean, there's all kinds of ways kids can get hurt.
Right. And where does that – where does the morality in this stop?
Where does the morality of what stop?
The morality
it sounds like,
of I'm going to hurt somebody.
It sounds like David's a little concerned.
Or is this going to hurt somebody?
He's asking if we abandon our – obedience to what the politicians give us as law, then
no,
what
I'm
becomes
not,
law?
Forget the obedience to the politicians. I'm talking about the, you know, the, is this going to hurt my fellow person or my neighbor or my fellow man? Not
well,
the
police are hurting
not the laws
neighbors.
That the politicians follow. Because the laws that the politicians put down, law enforcement has to enforce.
No, they don't. We've already been over this. Thank you for the call tonight, David. What were you trying to get out there, Dirce?
Well, it sounded to me like David is concerned. You know, it sounds like we all agree. You know, we don't want a bunch of murders. We don't want people doing violent stuff on the street. Mm-hmm. We're all on the same page there. But if a person starts to ignore the politicians' laws and start to use their own conscience instead, well, it starts to get a little murky, like, well, where do you draw the line? And I would say you draw the line at the non-aggression principle, that you make the rule, are we hurting anyone? And it seemed like that's where David was going. Like, if you're hurting, if there's someone that could get hurt, then you stop the action. If there's no one getting hurt, then you sort of look
the
other way.
Yeah, but if someone can get hurt by their own actions, like by virtue of taking drugs and taking too much or something like that, then that to me is not something the police should be involved in. That's someone choosing to do something with their own body, as tragic and as horrible as that might be for that individual. It doesn't justify the use of the force of the police to arrest that person.
No, sometimes
that's where we'll differ with him.
It sometimes would make their life worse if the police involved themselves in a crime where no one else is being harmed except for the victim.
But what about the children, Derek J? I mean, there could be a child blown up in a meth lab explosion.
What? Wait, huh?
An innocent child. I mean, these meth labs, the people making
they
meth
have
them.
They have them. They exist.
Are it's dangerous.
It's
There's chemicals.
Bad.
It could create fires.
Make it legal, and then it'll be made in a laboratory and not in somebody's home.
Yeah, but while it's illegal, then it is being made in people's homes, and shouldn't the police be trying to protect the children?
No, the police should be lobbying the politicians to stop sending them into meth labs, you know, that are people's homes and ruining families.
Yeah, maybe if the meth dealers knew they wouldn't get arrested for what they were doing, then they wouldn't have to do it in the back room of their house or in the shed or wherever it is they do it.
I just wish, you know, all these, any chemical, anything that people want to use could be made in a place where it's safe. And I don't think anyone wants a drug. Any kind of drug, whether it's aspirin or meth.
There's
that's
actually
made in a
legal meth. Did
backyard.
You know that?
No.
I forget the name of it right now, but if you look it up, there's actually a pharmaceutical company that makes a legal version of meth, and they make it in a controlled environment where it's safe and safely manufactured, which is how all drugs should be manufactured. And that's how it could be if we didn't have this crazy war on drugs. Let's continue here. We've got James. He's in Arizona via Skype. Hello, James.
Hey, sweetie pie.
Well, hi, sugar.
Hey, I took your dear leader's advice, Freeman's.
Who's that? Who's my dear leader?
you. And I, hey, Freeman, I went to After Hours Dance Club.
That
last
sounds
night,
fun.
Where they let in pretty much any females that look like they're old enough to drive. And boy, did I get more than just a hug. It's that easy to take advantage of a teenage girl. I know, it's that easy to take advantage of a teenage girl's still undeveloped brain, let alone her body.
Oh, right, right. So you're coming to the defense of teenagers everywhere. Now, do you think the same thing's true of teenage boys as well? Are they also?
Yeah, I was going to clubs underage as a teenage boy. So what about that, James?
Were you taken advantage of?
No, I was not.
May I continue on Free Talk Live? My point is, Minister, who you had the audacity of dope to question my Christianity last night. I fear God, and I love my neighbor, and I also, as the good Lord Jesus Christ commanded, I do not commit adultery, especially with a stupid, stupid, stupid girl.
Okay. Wow, that sounds a little misogynist, James. Thanks for the call tonight.
So weird.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Wow, he just sounds so Christian to me. I mean, that's clearly the language of a Christian, a loving Christian who cares about his fellow man.
Does he claim to be a Christian?
I think he does claim to be a Christian.
I don't buy that.
Yeah, I don't either. David's with us in, I don't know where. Is this? This isn't the same David who was on the line earlier, right?
Yeah, it is.
Sorry, David. We only have one call per night. That's our rule here, but you're welcome to call any other night of the week. We're happy to talk to you at that time. We don't have a whole lot of rules here on Free Talk Live, but the one call per night thing is something that we do.
Well, David asked before, is having a lawless society a good thing? Like, oh, do you want anarchy? Mm-hmm. And some people say throwing that word around does a disservice to those who are in favor of having a stateless society, but I'll just go out there and say it. I don't want a lawless society, but I think anarchy is attractive because to me that means that I am in charge of my life, that my conscience makes a difference, that I can interact with other peaceful humans on a free basis. So I'm not coerced into interacting with you, Ian, or you listeners, that all of my relationships are voluntary, and that's attractive.
Yes, and we have more of those now that we're here in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. You can go if you love the ideas of liberty and check out the Free State Project's website, freestateproject.org, where you can move to be together with a community full of people who gets the idea of voluntary, consensual interaction between people. And we'll come back with more tomorrow night. You can join us online in the meantime and join Derek J on his website, derekj.me. See you tomorrow.
Deep Free Talk Live.
And I use the downsizeddc.org system for responding to my Congress critters and talking to the thieves and liars and despots in Washington, D.C. And in these letters, they outline the issue for me. Then they flush it down the toilet. And it's so demeaning.
Yeah.
They just don't care what I think. I can tell them,
pretend like he cares if he's trying to get elected.
They only care what you think if you're giving them a check with, five digits on it. Then you might be able to get them to do something.
Yeah.
But that's just one senator among the 535 disgusting, dishonorable thieves. What's a guy to do? These lobbying groups, they run Washington. Washington has been taken over. It does not belong to the American people. It doesn't do anything for the American people. It is a bad, bad place.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, December 29th, 2014. Silver is trading at $16.11 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,193 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $319. Antiwar.com reports, for years, the U.S. was wondering what it was going to do with many thousands of war vehicles it shipped to Afghanistan when the drawdown left so many of them in surplus. At times, they talked about giving them away or shredding them. Instead, 3,100 such vehicles have been sent to Kuwait, where the U.S. is massing them for use in the ever-escalating war against the Islamic State. Officials simply found another war for them. The bulk of the vehicles are MRAPs, used by ground troops to resist IEDs and travel, and that points to the buildup being done with an eye on an eventual U.S. ground war in Iraq and Syria.